Hola amigos, soy Blanca, your online Spanish teacher, and I'm here today with a complex matter in Spanish, and it is the word law. If you're a beginner, this may be overwhelming, but I promise it will be really helpful, and it is for you, because this lesson, this video lesson, has been inspired for one of my beginner students. So, and if you're intermediate or advanced, this will be amazing, because probably it clears out some doubts that you might be having regarding law. Okay, let's start with the simple thing that everyone knows or learns first. Law is a pronombre objeto directo, yeah? And we use it to talk about things that we already mentioned, yeah? Por ejemplo, leo el periódico. We can say lo leo, right? And it's I read it. Perfecto. Or we can, in this case, we use lo if we are talking about a thing that we previously mentioned that is masculine singular, yeah? El periódico. But we can also use it when it's an abstract thing or an idea, a concept. Such is the case of no lo entiendo, I don't understand it, I don't understand the concept that you are trying to explain. Yeah? Or no lo sé, I don't know it. The thing, the, yeah? It's a bit abstract. That's what I told my student, and he went home, shout out to Keith, study, and he's living in Spain now. So he was watching TV and saw a commercial, and the commercial said, lo que haces por tu perro. And when we have a lesson, if he say, Blanca, I've been studying and I watched this ad, and I don't think in this case, lo que haces por tu perro is lo means it. What it is? Okay, so in this kind of construction, it can have several meanings, but I'm gonna give you the tip so you don't get crazy. Lo means the thing. Yeah? So, if you see the sentence, lo que haces por tu perro, you can say, la cosa que haces por tu perro. So, the thing that you do for your dog, right? The most popular combination, I think, is to use lo plus an adjective. And when we use it that way, in English, will be the adjective plus thing, yeah? For example, lo bueno. Lo bueno will be the good thing. Yeah? I know it might be sound at first, but let's practice. Let's see some examples, right? Okay, let's see then some examples with the construction lo plus adjective. That in English, we will translate it as the plus the adjective plus thing. For example, lo bueno. Lo bueno in English will be the good thing. For example, lo bueno de España is the good thing about Spain is. Another example could be lo interesante de la historia es, and you add whatever you want to it. That in English, Google say the interesting thing about the story is blah, blah, blah. Miguel fue lo suficientemente listo para no decir nada. Miguel was the smart enough thing to not say anything. As you see, we say the smart enough thing. In English, you will say Miguel was smart enough to not say anything. But still, this proves the point that lo can be a substitute by the thing. It doesn't matter if the thing is a person, an object, an animal, it just can be used, right? And if you see in all these examples that we have seen, it's always lo, masculine singular. We don't make it plural, regardless of what comes after, yeah? And the thing that comes after is always masculine plural as well. Lo bueno, lo interesante.
right? And Miguel was in this one, in the last one, Miguel was smart enough. It's not an adjective, it's an adverb. But still, we use it lo, right? Another popular construction can be lo plus adjective plus de plus infinitive. That in English is translated as de plus adjective plus thing plus of plus gerund. It's a bit complicated, but it will make sense with the example. Lo malo de viajar en coche. Then in English will be the bad thing about traveling by car.
As you saw in those examples, lo is always masculine singular. Sometimes it refers to a thing, sometimes it refers to an animal, even a person or an idea. But the main thing is that all the time can be a substitute by la cosa, the thing, right? Another common use is to say lo que. Again, lo que, following the pattern that we have seen, can be lo, can be la cosa, the thing. So lo que, it is the thing that. Imagina, olvida lo que dije ayer. Forget about the thing I said yesterday. Yeah? Let's see some more examples.
Okay, let's see some examples now for lo que. That, what we said, can be translated as the thing that, right? So have a look to lo que haces por tu perro, the sentence that started all. Can be translated like the thing or the things that you do for your dog. Another example, no preguntaron lo que estudié en el examen. That can be translated as they didn't ask what I study in the exam, right? The literal translation. But if to prove the point that lo always gonna mean think, we can see they didn't ask the thing or the things I study in the exam, right? So it doesn't matter if you choose to say another way in English because it's more natural, but still you can use the thing. And the last one, lo que es peor. Lo que es peor means the thing that is worse.
Right, now we are going to see lo de. Very popular as well. And lo de, following the same sense, is lo de, the thing about, yeah? Lo de vacaciones fue mentira. We can translate it that the thing about the holidays was a lie. Yeah? That makes sense. A lot of time we need to figure it out what is the thing that we are talking about. Like in this case, lo de las vacaciones, the thing about the holiday. What was it? Was it a gossip? Was it a story? What was it?
Okay, let's see now some examples for the structure lo de. Lo de, as we said, is the thing about. Have a look to the sentences. Lo de hoy ha sido mejor. The thing about today has been better. And the thing can be anything, really. Sometimes you just, as I said, you are gonna just have trouble to understand what is the thing that you are talking about. But that, as a translation, works. Lo de mentir tiene consecuencias. The thing about lying has consequences. Works, right? And what about lo de estudiar español es verdad. The thing about studying Spanish is true. It can be a gossip, it can be a confession you made to your friend, but it is true. And lo again appears as the thing, right?
Yeah, that we are talking about lo. And lo can be used as the thing all the time. And that's it, my friends. That's the lesson that I wanted to teach you about lo. I hope this small tip makes your Spanish learning smoother. Remember that, again, lo can have several meanings, and all the books are going to say something different. But I want to teach you something that works and that you can use it and not get your brain crazy in this situation. So let me know below if this helped. And if you really like my videos, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because it really supports my work. Now, I let you to think about law, the thing, and I will see you next week. Hasta pronto!